Decades ago, science fiction offered a hypothetical scenario. What if alien life were thriving in an ocean beneath the icy surface of Jupiter's moon, Europa? The notion pulled Europa out of obscurity and into the limelight, where it has remained, stalking the imaginations of people both within and outside the science community who fantasize about humans discovering life beyond Earth. There is even a really nice movie on this amazing moon by the name of Europa Report. Europa has long intrigued scientists because the moon has a subsurface ocean beneath a thick shell of ice. Plumes of water have been known to erupt from cracks in the ice shell, releasing the contents of the moon's alien ocean into space. Jupiter's second Galilean moon, Europa, is one of the most fascinating planetary objects in our solar system, along with Io, Ganymede, and Callisto. Astronomer Galileo Galilei gets the credit for discovering these moons among the largest in the solar system. Europa is the smallest of the four, but it is one of the more intriguing satellites. Europa might be the best place to search for life elsewhere in the solar system. Scientists are almost certain that beneath the Jovian moon's frozen surface is a salty ocean with more water than all of Earth's ocean combined. And such a watery subsurface environment could provide a comfortable home for small European life forms. Scientists got their best evidence that a European ocean might exist 2 decades ago, when that earlier NASA spacecraft detected a magnetic connection between Europa and Jupiter that could easily be explained by the presence of a salty global sea. This deep into the solar system, Europa's underground ocean would not feel the warmth of the sun. It would stay liquid because of Jupiter's gravitational tugging. Europa orbits Jupiter in just over 3.5 days, with an orbital radius of about 670,900 km. Europa is tightly locked to Jupiter, with one hemisphere of Europa constantly facing Jupiter. Because of this, there is a sub-Jovian point on Europa's surface from which Jupiter would appear to hang directly overhead. Scientists believe that Europa's ocean could be as old as the moon itself, about 4 billion years or so, which would give life plenty of time and a stable environment in which to evolve. Evidence for the shallow pools not far beneath the frozen surface of the Jovian moon emerged when scientists noticed that giant parallel ridges stretching for hundreds of miles on Europa were strikingly similar to surface features discovered on the Greenland ice sheet. If the extensive ice ridges that crisscross Europa formed in a similar way to those in Greenland, then pockets of subsurface water may be ubiquitous on the body and help circulate chemicals necessary for life from the icy shell down to the salty ocean that lurks far beneath. At 2,000 miles wide, Europa is slightly smaller than Earth's moon. It is the 6th largest moon and 15th largest object in the solar system. It became a leading contender in the search for life elsewhere when observations from ground-based telescopes and passing space probes found evidence of a deep ocean 10 to 15 miles beneath its icy surface. Europa's ocean is estimated at 40 to 100 miles deep, so even though it is 1/4 the width of Earth, it may hold twice as much water as all of Earth's ocean combined. Because it did not like any known substance on Earth, the chemical signature of the red streaks on Europa's surface, which are believed to be a frozen mixture of water and salts, seemed strange. Scientists say the red color likely comes from an unknown mixture of ice and salts from within the moon. Now, an international team of researchers has announced a possible reason, a newly discovered form of salty ice. Researchers from the University of Washington led the new study and announced it on February 21, 2023. Right now, scientists have only seen the newly discovered form of salty ice in the lab. The researchers created it by simulating the cold and high pressure conditions found beneath the ice crust on the icy moons. But it may just be the answer that they have been looking for. It could explain the unusual streaks on Europa and features on other icy moons as well, if it does exist there. The recipe for a substance is simple. Sodium chloride, known as table salt, and its edible form, and water. Both are common, but the unique conditions inside the icy moons could produce a more exotic form of salty ice. Europa is the smoothest known object in the solar system, lacking large-scale features such as mountains and craters. However, according to one study, Europa's equator may be covered in icy spikes called penitents, which may be up to 15 meters high due to direct overhead sunlight on the equator, causing the ice to sublime, forming vertical cracks. Europa's most striking surface features are a series of dark streaks crisscrossing the entire globe called lineae. The most likely hypothesis is that the lineae on Europa were produced by a series of eruptions of warm ice as Europa's crust slowly spreads open to expose warmer layers beneath. These various fractures are thought to have been caused in large part by the tidal flexing exerted by Jupiter. Europa's surface temperature averages about minus 160 degrees centigrade or minus 260 degrees Fahrenheit at the equator and only minus 220 degrees centigrade or minus 370 degrees Fahrenheit at the poles, keeping Europa's icy crust as hard as granite. Europa receives heat from tidal heating, which occurs through the tidal friction and tidal flexing process caused by tidal acceleration. Orbital and rotational energy are dissipated as heat in the core of the moon, the internal ocean, and the ice crust. The Hubble Space Telescope acquired an image of Europa in 2012 that was interpreted to be a plume of water vapors erupting from near its south pole. The image suggests the plumes may be 200 km, 120 miles high, or more than 20 times the height of Mount Everest, though recent observations and modeling suggest that typical European plumes may be much smaller. The estimated eruption rate at Europa is about 7,000 kg per second compared to about 200 kg per second for the plumes of Enceladus. The atmosphere of Europa can be characterized as thin and tenuous, often called an exosphere, primarily composed of oxygen and trace amounts of water vapor. However, this quantity of oxygen is produced in a non-biological manner. Given that Europa's surface is icy and subsequently very cold, as solar ultraviolet radiation and charged particles from the Jovian magnetospheric environment collide with Europa's surface, water vapor is created and instantaneously separated into oxygen and hydrogen constituents. As it continues to move, the hydrogen is light enough to pass through the surface gravity of the atmosphere, leaving behind only oxygen. Europa's gravity is approximately 13% of Earth's. Conjectures regarding extraterrestrial life have ensured a high profile for Europa and have led to steady lobbying for future missions. The aims of these missions have ranged from examining Europa's chemical composition to searching for extraterrestrial life in its hypothesized subsurface ocean. Set to launch in 2024, Europa Clipper will study the Moon's atmosphere, surface and interior, with its main science goal being to determine whether there are places below Europa's surface that could support life. The probe will swing past the Moon dozens of times, sometimes coasting just 60 miles, 25 kilometers above the surface. Each pass will bring scientists closer to understanding the workings of this celestial truffle and its mysterious interior. Beneath that frosty coating could be the answer to one of our biggest questions: is there life anywhere else in the universe?